program, the Occident Hour of Smiles, starring your old softy, Bert Healy. A moment of tears. Say something.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
But still, remember, folks.
Smile, darn your smile.
Right way. Smile, darn your smile. Well, say, Wacky, who's that who just walked into our WEAF studio?
Why, it's not other than the Wacky and Gotchess. I'm all straight by come. I'm a
very warm. Thank you for coming on. Now, all of the gorgeous, I understand you have something to tell the folks at home about wonderful little Annie here.
Yes, good evening, Bert Healy. Annie is an 11-year-old foundling who was left by her parents on the steps of New York's municipal orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And aren't you now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents?
Yes, Bert Healy, I'm now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Draw page. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
Wow! So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station, WEAF New York, or directly to him
at my home, Berkeley.
In the microphone.
At my home. At my home, 9087 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
And I would like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of all new Occident toothpaste with Miracle L64 to fight red breath for letting me appear this evening. And I just did a damn commercial! God, Christ! I've never told you anything in my life.
Good night, Oliver Warbucks. Thanks for dropping by, Oliver Warbucks. So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, there's $50,000! And a wonderful daughter waiting for you. So get in touch right away, you hear?
Hey, Mr. Healy, isn't it time once again for the lovely Violin Sisters?
It most certainly is, Wacky. Well, it looks like by the old clock on the wall that another one of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Occident. The toothpaste of the stars.
To make your teeth Hollywood bright.
So for all the Hour of Smiles family, Ronnie, Bonnie, and Connie, the lovely Boylan sisters, Fred McCracken,
and Blackie,
and Jimmy Johnson, right here's only fast.
This is Bert Healy saying, hey, hobo man, hey, dapper Dan, you both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be both rumbly, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Who cares what they're wearing on Main Street or Savile Row? It's what you wear from ear to ear and not from head to toe that matters.
So,
Senator,
so,
ready
or not, here he goes. Listen to Bert tap his smiling toes.
Ah, the lovely Boylan sisters!
you. So, for all the Hour of Smiles family, this is Bert Healy saying, ha, 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 ha. Hey, Hoberman, hey, Zapper, and you both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be both grumbly, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
$50,000.
I hate that Annie so much. You think I was her mother.
Excuse us. Ma'am, we knocked upstairs, but nobody answered. Are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah.
Oh, Ralph, I'm scared. Something could have happened to
us. Oh, hush, Shirley. It's gonna be all right, Shirley. She's gonna be here, and she's gonna be ours again. Ma'am?
What do you want?
Oh, well, we had terrible troubles back then. We had to head north to Canada. Had to leave our baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl, our Annie. Oh.
Annie? Your Annie's parents?
Oh, please, nothing's happened to her.
Can't believe it, Annie's parents. Where'd you say you come from again?
Oh, we come from a farm in Canada.
Manitoba.
Where they got lots of chickens.
Little chickens.
And ducks.
Ducks.
And geese.
Oh, you should have seen all the geese.
And roosters. Gotcha, sis.
I never would have known it was you in 100 years.
Oh, we fooled you, Aggie. And we're gonna fool Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
Oh, this is gonna be the best bunco job ever, Aggie. I know a guy in a jail who could doctor up a fake birth certificate or any of the papers you want. But we need your help, sis. For details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
So Sure, I could help you. A lot. But, what's in it for me, Ralph?
Three-way split, Aggie.
Half.
Half?
Half.
Half! Straight down the middle! 25 grand each! But we gotta make it fast, you know, give him some of the old Rooster Razzle Dazzle. In and out, 2-3 minutes at the most. Get the money, get the kid, and then get the hell out of town.
Yeah, the kid. Annie, that's your problem. What do you do with the raft word?
Aggie, that's no problem.
When the rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
For good.
Rooster.
Come on, Aggie. We get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy little town, and then a little me'll meet ya.
Where? Oh, yeah.
Easy Street.
Cloud has a silver lining? You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Oliver Warbucks and friend, Franklin.
Thank you, Louis. Show them in.
Yes, sir. Oliver?
Ah, Oliver. Good of you to have come.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Well, who is this we have here?
This is my good friend, Annie.
Annie?
Yes, she so wanted to meet you, I couldn't resist bringing her along just to say hello.
Of course. The little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
That's right. Annie, this is the President, President Roosevelt.
Well, it's nice to meet you, President Roosevelt.
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, if you'll wait outside.
No, no, Oliver. Let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us on our best behavior.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Harold, I don't want to hear even so much as a gosh out of you.
But Franklin, really? A child?
Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your views on matters.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country
is business.
Yes, and for the good of you, this country, Wall Street, and me, we need to get my factories open again and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work.
and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
But Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not the worst of our problems. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing every day. There could be war!
Germany? How? People are starving in this country.
Harold, I know, but in the long run, we have
Wardell, for people who are starving, they have no long run.
No, the problem is it's happening all at once. The stock market is taking it in the nosedive.
Sit down strikes, riots.
Floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone. Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing, and that's the situation is getting worse.
Henry, I want to see those figures.
Tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be.
Shh! Quiet, little girl.
Harold. What did you say, Annie? No, it's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow. Here's a way the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just think of my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow.
Stand up.
What?
You heard me? Stand up. Up, up, up. Now, Harold, sing.
Sing?
Yes, sing, like Annie. I just decided that if this administration is going to be anything, it's going to be optimistic about the future of our country. Now sing.
But really, frankly, you know...
Sing.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow.
Lower Hill.
There'll be sun.
Perkins.
Just thinking about tomorrow.
There's a way to cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's
so long for the president. Except for the day that's gray and lonely. I just stick out my chin, up my chin and grin. And say, harmony, everybody, longer, Republicans too.
Tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow.
Secretary in New York. Hundreds of couples jamming street outside house, all claiming to be Annie's parents.
Oh boy!
Have begun to screen them. Suggest you return to New York at once. Signed, Grace Farrell.
Well, Annie, it looks like the Hour of Smiles had more listeners than we thought.
Oh, gee, hundreds of couples. One of them is bound to be my mother and father.
Well, Oliver, I suspect you better get back to New York immediately.
Yes, if you don't mind, Mr. President. Come on in.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Annie.
And goodbye, Mr. President. And thank you.
No, thank you, Annie. You're the kind of person a president should have around him.
What if we set up, what if we set up 1,000 federal projects?
Damn!
Yes.
Highways?
Yes.
New post offices?
Yes. And put the unemployed to work building them.
We could create 5 million new jobs within 6 months.
And we could pay checks between the millions off
from
income tax and taxes.
We could build a country so strong that nobody, including Chancellor Hitler, could ever defeat us in a war.
Mr. President, what we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new concept.
A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new vision.
A new attitude.
A new... deal. Perkins, gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, I love you, tomorrow, you're only a day away.
Party! Tomorrow, I love you, tomorrow, you're only a day.
No sign of Mr. Warbucks and Miss Annie.
Drake, look at all these questionnaires. Do you realize that I talked to 617 women who've claimed to be Annie's mother, and 619 men who've said that they were her father? That makes, let me see.
1,236.
All liars. Drake, I never realized that there were so many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some of them were from the Bronx, miss.
Grace, we're back.
Gone, dear. They've come and gone. I'm sorry, Annie, but they were all liars and fakes, after nothing but the $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
Gee, I thought for sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Warbucks, this just came by special messenger from the FBI.
Oh, finally. Elliot Ness has located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
That sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1924.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
90,000?
Annie, I'm afraid the gist of it is that Elliot Ness doesn't feel like there's one chance in a million of tracing your parents through the locket. I'm sorry, dear.
It's okay. I mean, gee, you did the best you could. You can't find them. Nobody can.
I guess you could tank along without folks. I mean, you didn't turn out so bad.
You've got everything. With all the deuce and birds hanging on the wall and everything.
Excuse us, sir. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Annie. Annie, a Duesenberg is a car. Babe Ruth is a right fielder in the New York Yankees. And there's something else you should know. I made me a fortune, that fortune may tend. Been headlined and profiled again and again. Yet something was missing, I never quite knew. That something was someone, but who? My speeches are greeted with thunderous acclaim at two universities bearing my name. But something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone, but who? Who could that someone be? How could she make it known? Who would need me for me? Need me for me? The world was my oyster, but where was the pearl? Who dreamed I would find it in one little girl? Yes, something was missing, but dreams can come true. That something is no one but you. Come on. Come on. Stand on my feet.
What?
Stand on my feet. Here we go. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One. One, two, three. One. Good. Those legal papers I gave you the other day.
I'll get them right away.
Wait, Grace. I want you to stay a moment. Pretty good for an old man, huh? I haven't waltzed like that since J.P. Morgan went bust. Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Uh-huh. Yes or no?
Well, if I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have her father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, Annie. Drake! Drake!
Yes, sir.
Drake, call Justice Brandeis and tell him to come over here and sign those adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Adoption papers. Oh, Grace! Grace!
Yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Pugh that we'll have a house full of guests. Let's see, we'll need flowers.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
Champagne.
Champagne.
Annie, this isn't going to be just an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anybody in the world you want to come to it. So who would you like? Babe Ruth? Johnny Rockefeller? Madam Chiang Kai-shek? She's a lot of fun. Of course, that's who I'd like to. Drake?
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
What about the kids?
It'll be way past their bedtime. But I tell you what, tomorrow we'll have everyone from the orphanage over here tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Sure, Miss Hannigan, too. Why not?
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is getting. And these are your words, sir. Spiffed up for the party.
Oh, well, I think Annie and I should get spiffed up, too. Annie. Grace. Grace. Have Miss Cecile put... Why, Grace, that's a very pretty dress you have on.
Thank you, sir.
Have Cecile put Annie in a new dress and have Annette do something with her hair. Just take her upstairs and, I don't know, gussy her up.
Yes, sir.
Yesterday between all
you can say that again.
Again. Yesterday between all.
down all of them.
Now, Oliver, Annie, we're ready to begin. The adoption procedure is very simple. And according to the laws of the state of New York, you must...
Sir!
Oh, what?
Sir!
Excuse us, folks. We don't mean to interrupt, but... Shirley, look! There's our Annie!
Who are you? Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Mudge. Mudge is the name. Ralph Mudge. And this here's the wife, Shirley.
You never knew it, dear, but you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
Oh, we were sick and broke, honey. We didn't know which way to turn. And a man gave us a chance to work on his farm in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
Oh, we loved you, honey, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people today.
Oh, proof. I trust we want proof of who we are, so here's our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl, name Ann Elizabeth Mudge. Born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge. New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th? That's my birthday!
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know, but I still don't...
Mister, please, you gotta believe us. We got on the Greyhound this afternoon, and we went straight to the orphanage to fetch our Annie. And the lady there said our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie, all the years I've dreamed of holding you in my arms again. Mr. Mudge, on the night that...
And here's something you wouldn't know about. On the night we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half the silver locket with her, and we kept the other half, so it's one day we...
Annie's wearing it!
And here's the part we kept. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph. She's our Annie.
She is. She is.
She seems to be.
Well, if you'll be getting her things together, we'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No!
No.
Just a minute, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever you need.
You haven't heard that I was offering a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who could prove that they were Annie's parents?
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
Oh, good.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Shirley, remember that pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could buy it. We could afford to bring Annie up right in the country with fresh air and fresh eggs.
Fresh ham!
Fresh ham! Certified, huh? All I gotta do is make it out to myself?
Yeah, that's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Yes, you wouldn't mind if we kept Annie until tomorrow morning, Christmas. Then you can come by and pick up Annie and the check.
Oh.
Oh.
Problem?
No, sir. Whatever you prefer, sir. Well, I think we better be getting back to the hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Until tomorrow, honey. Then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us.
Oh, goodbye, Annie, love.
Goodbye, all. Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Merry Christmas!
Season's greetings, one and all!
Well, Annie, this is wonderful news.
Wonderful news.
Annie has found her mother and father, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
Mm. You're lucky, Annie.
I'm lucky. Just think. A pig farm.
Mrs. Greer Champagne.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, we must celebrate because it's Christmas Eve and because we've had the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father. I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie, Annie.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, I seem to have the same effect on everyone.
Oh, I've lost her. I've lost my Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember where or when. But I have the strangest feeling that he's not who he says he is.
Mr. President.
Franklin.
Franklin. Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do for you.
Let's talk about it. I'll see you.
Well, you're up early, too.
We've been up all night, and we've had quite a time of it, with FBI men coming and going. Annie, did you know that President Roosevelt is here?
Really?
Really. Annie, I have something very difficult to tell you, and the president is going to help me tell it to you.
Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. It's good to see you again.
You too, sir.
Franklin, can...
Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and the handwriting on your note, he succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know that. Mr. and Mrs. Butt. What?
No, Annie, they're not your parents. Your real parents were David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie.
Your mother and your father passed away a long time ago.
You mean the dead?
Yeah. Yes, dear.
So, I'm an orphan after all. Like the other kids? Are you all right, Annie? Yes. Because I guess I always knew my folks were dead. Because I knew they loved me. And they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Atta girl. Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could easily have been forged, but the thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket, that's your key.
But no one knew about the locket, except for us and the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan. It's Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Ah, Miss Hannigan. Delighted to meet you.
Same here. And I'd know you anywheres. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
Yes, that's right, Miss Hannigan. Let me introduce you to everyone. You know my secretary, Miss Farrell, of course.
Yeah.
And this is the President of the United States.
Sure.
And this is my butler, Drake.
Miss Hannigan, that isn't necessary. You come on, let's seat over here.
Show them in.
With pleasure, sir.
Franklin, shall I have them call your car for you?
No. Eleanor can wait.
Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Madge?
Good morning.
Good morning.
And Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Drake.
Christmas.
There she is, our little girl.
Your little girl?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hello, Dean.
Well, we don't want to bother you on Christmas and all. We just come to pick up Annie and her suitcase.
Oh, allow me.
Oh, and the check.
Ah, yes, the check. Let's see, I'd almost forgotten. Here you are, Mr. Mudge. $50,000 certified.
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 Paid to the order of Ralph Mudge.
Oh, I read it again.
Paid to the order of... The jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known
no,
as...
Mr. Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dick.
No, wait.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Franklin, I do believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your Secret Service men have the right to arrest.
Yes, Oliver, they certainly do. Drake, will you turn them over?
Yes, sir.
Deck the halls with bags of holly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Solo for Warbucks. And this woman is their accomplice. La 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 la. Arrest her too.
Me? I never seen these people till yesterday.
Oh, come off it, Annie!
Yes, sister, fooling me has taken a fall. So are you,
Mr. Warbucks, Oliver. I never done nothing to you. I always been straight up and on.
The jig is up.
Annie, tell him how good and nice I always was to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you always taught me? Never tell a lie.
You brat! I'll let you in on a secret. I never liked you, you little gold digger. And I never liked any of you either.
You! You're a
digger,
never.
Let me out!
Hi, kids.
Hannigan is gone for good.
Yay!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Instead, you'll have classes with teachers.
Yay!
Yeah! The listening is fixed. No more mush!
No more mush! No more mush! No more mush!
Yes, yes, girls, for you and perhaps for all of us. This Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. I know the depression's depressing.
The candles are still, the stores are filled.
And windows are minus their dressing.
The children don't grin, the Santas are thin.
And I've heard a terrible rumor. No goodwill, no cheer, but we'll get a new deal for Christmas this year.
The snowflakes are bright and falling.
No ornaments, the peppermint
sticks. And all through the land, folks are bawling.
And filled with despair, his covers are bare.
But Santa's got brand new assistants. There's nothing to fear. They're bringing a new deal for Christmas.
On Farley and Perkins, on Hickey's and Wallace, on Morgantown and Cummins, fill our pockets with the odds, on Roper and Swanson.
Get along for the fall.